Hi there. This week I'm going to share 10 tips that I believe could help you be successful when you want to access the Chinese market, when you want to enter China or you're doing business in China. 10 tips. I'm going to do this in 10 minutes. But before that, I want to share that I'm also every month doing a podcast with four of my colleagues at Nexworks. We're all keynote speakers or have our expertise in our own field. And every month, we're talking about innovation, technology, business, something that is newsworthy. And then we're all giving our own lens and our own interpretation on these events in the world. And so do subscribe to the iTunes or Spotify. I'll share in the comments and in the description. So hope to see you also there. But definitely, let's get started with the 10 tips to be successful in China. So I'm going to share 10 tips that took me 10 years to learn doing business in China on how to be successful in China by accessing the Chinese market. Now, the first one is think like a startup. And very often when we go to China, want to access the Chinese market, what we do is we don't think like a startup because we've had successes outside China. We've got markets, we got customers, we got products, we got lots of stuff. And we believe that if we just have the right strategy for China, this will work. It won't. You have to start from scratch again. You have to start from zero. Going into China is like starting like a startup. You have to find customers, your first customers, find maybe money, you have to find partners, employees. You need to do all these things and you need to constantly change, adapt, be creative, be agile, all these words that startups know. It's like a rainforest. You don't know where success will be. And it's not because you had success outside China that you can copy paste that for China. So think like a startup, and I had one. And as you see on these pictures, it's really about working really hard, but also playing hard. And that's the fun of startups, but also the pain. Now, the second thing is start small. Think big, dream big, but start small and don't delay it. One of the biggest mistakes that I've seen companies do when they enter the Chinese market is they constantly are flying over to China to talk to distributors. Of course, now we can't fly anymore, but they're doing Zoom calls. We're going to trade fairs. It's like a million discussions. And they delay, delay, delay. And that's because they think about this huge market and it's very, very complicated to get into this market. Shouldn't think like that. Think small. Go into one city, go into Yiwu, go into Yixing, go into Huzhou, a city you might have never heard about, but which is very close to Hangzhou, to Nanjing, to Shanghai. And so try your success in a small place. Think bottom up. And once you have some successes, what you need to do is listen. You need to have these big ears and constantly have a radar on the market. And then if something works, one product or one service for one type of customer, define that. And then you go into the big cities and then you start having your strategy. Now, the third thing to do is don't trust your gut. And that might be very surprising because that's exactly what people do, especially successful people. They go into China and they say, well, we have this business outside China. I know how it works. I know my market. I know my experts. I know how customers react. I know everything. So if something happens, then they trust their gut, their instinct to say, this is what we need to do. And the problem is, this often derails you. It often sends you off on the wrong path, the wrong strategy, and you end up somewhere not successful. Now, what you need to do is actually trust the people around you. You need to trust the data. You need to trust the results. Constantly analyze your successes and then go with that and grow it, scale it from there. Don't trust your gut. Trust everything around you. Now, the fourth thing is that you need to have an unfair advantage. And think about the Red Devils, the national football team in Belgium. I mean, if they would go to any football team in China, they would win probably 5-0 or 10-0 or 10-1 or whatever. I mean, they would beat them anytime, any day. And that is because they're really, really good. So if you want to go into the Chinese market, you have to be really good. You have to have some product, some quality, some expertise, some service that's very unique, or a brand or reputation. You need to have something that is not available in China. And this is a mistake many companies make, because when they go into China, they think, well, everybody else wants it, so the Chinese will also want it. But if the Chinese can do it, They will outcompete you on price, on speed. It's going to be very, very difficult to keep that advantage. So lots of companies, think about Best Buy, for example, or MediaMart. They went into China. They sold the exact same products as the Chinese vendors, Chinese stores did, electronics. And 2 years later, they were out of the market. They thought because we have a better location in Shanghai or Beijing, we're going to make it. They didn't. So you have to have that unfair advantage. The fifth thing is you have to localize. And that is very important. And anybody who's worked in China, specifically today, where you see that the culture is becoming so important for Chinese, unless you localize, you have no chance of becoming successful. You have to understand the consumer, understand the customer. They're different from the global one. And so some companies like Disney, like KFC, like Coca-Cola have been very successful at it. Another company like Barbie dolls from Mattel has been terrible at it. And the simple reason is Chinese kids, they didn't grow up, Chinese girls didn't grow up with Barbie dolls. So they had no idea what this culture was about. So they had to instill that culture. Now what they did is they went in Shanghai, sent the biggest flagship store, showed this great store, fantastic opening, I went to the opening, but nobody bought the dolls. And the simple reason they didn't buy the dolls is because it wasn't localized to the local culture. If you don't localize, stay away. Do cross-border trade. Maybe you can do some other types of distributor that you can find, but don't go into the market. Now the sixth thing, and that might sound very unlogical or illogical, is really don't be patient. Be impatient and be very assertive. And very often people say, yeah, for China, you need to be very patient. I disagree completely with that. You constantly need to chase people. You need to chase them. You need to check them. You need to double check if they've done their work. And it's not because you can't trust them. It's because their priorities are often very different than yours. They want to make money. And if someone else can make them more money, or they have another thing that they have as a priority, then basically they're not going to put you as a highest priority. Even if they told you they would, they might derail themselves because they see the market different than you do. So you have to chase them. And once you do, and constantly be very assertive about it, be direct about it, don't just be respectful. But if you do that, then they will understand that this is serious, this is a high priority. And so they will put their act together or get their act together and get faster. And this is how you do business in China. Now, the seventh thing is something I've learned the hard way. Expect the unexpected. If you go into the office every day in China, every day what I did is like, okay, something will have gone wrong today. And every time I had that attitude, usually it was okay. But when I went into the office and I just thought, yeah, today will be the same as yesterday, then suddenly something very unexpected happened, and often not very good. And so I often had to solve problems. And so if you expect the problems, it's actually easier to deal with it. It doesn't mean that China is full of problems, but there's a lot of challenges for sure. But it's also because Chinese do things different than we do. They have different habits. They've been building these things for 20 years in a different way. And so they just do whatever they did before. And so unless you guide them and you tell them and you train them, you're going to expect a lot of unexpected. And so this is really something of a mindset. It's about looking at the world differently and be very curious about it. And I would call the world serendipity, because it's not just negative. There's a lot of positive, because the unexpected can give you a lot of energy and opportunity. Now, the eighth thing that I think the most important is stay positive. And too often I've seen foreigners going to China, and after a few months they become extremely negative. You can't trust the employees, you can't trust this distributor. I mean, the supplier is late again. And what's the government now doing with this regulation, and what's happening in Beijing? And so they become negative more and more. And once you get negative, what happens is that the Chinese will feel that. They will have their gut tell them you don't trust them. You're not positive about the market, about your partners, about your employees. And so you're starting to doubt them. As soon as that happens, your success is over, because that's when everybody's going to start to work against you. So stay positive regardless, and you'll be amazing. This is a roller coaster that sometimes it's hard, but other times it's like exciting and great news. Think about Ant Financial. They know all about staying positive even when everything is against you. Or Huawei, for an example. Now, the ninth thing is really trust the people and learn to work with the people to become successful. Regardless how good your products are, your quality is, your services are, your expertise is, it's not going to make a difference. You might have an unfair advantage, but unless you work with people and find the best team that you trust and they trust you, you're not going to make it in China. Chinese businesses, it's all about becoming successful because of the people that you surround you with. And so this is something I've learned. And I would always advise, if you want to go into China, invest more money in the people than you would invest in the market, specifically the first year. If you do that right, hire an accountant first because you need to get the books right, and then hire a great manager, hire great people, and make friends with them. That's the way to do it. And talking about making friends, the one thing you should really do is to make friends in the government. And I don't mean to that you need to do this to get relationships and to get licenses and to get benefits. And no, that's not what it's about. You need to get friendly with people in the government because that's the only way to understand how China works. And so one of my very good friends who passed away sadly now was Ding Baohua. He used to be the ambassador in Luxembourg, Chinese ambassador, and was a very good friend, and his wife as well. I mean, she was actually a higher position even than he was. I mean, great friends. We traveled a lot of places, and I did it not because I wanted to get benefits or I wanted to get something special. I did it because these were real friends. And the result is that if you help them, they will help you. And so that's exactly what you need. And they have all the relationships and they know the people to do it. But don't go straight to the target. Just make friends and you'll learn a lot. And so I believe, regardless which industry you're in, regardless if it's B2C, B2B, or B2B2C, or business to government, whatever it is, keep these 10 tips in mind. And you're probably going to have a higher chance to become successful. I hope this was helpful. And in the comments, if you have more tips, write them. I will answer them. And we can have a dialogue and discussion on the other tips that you may have to succeed in the Chinese market. See you next week for another Pascal's China Lens.